There is a saying that if there is no enemy inside, there is no enemy to be feared outside. So join me. My name is Sarah from Unlock Your Life. And allow me to guide you in your journey towards greater freedom, wholeness, and peace of mind. As you settle down deeper, know that you can pause or end this journey at any time, and also return at any time. Those of you who already know my work will also trust my guidance by now, and know that I will always empower you. And as you inhale now, close your eyes and breathe. Take a couple more breaths, and as you do now, allow yourself to feel as if you sink deeper and deeper inside your own mind. And on every exhale, feel your awareness drifting down. Deeper and deeper. As every breath is light, you feel yourself drifting now. Drifting into the parts of you that you have not acknowledged. As you get calmer and calmer, feel yourself moving forward with open arms and hands, setting off on this journey to reintegrate all parts of you into a stronger self. As I count down now with every number, you'll feel yourself get calmer and go to a whole other level of awareness, deeper and more acutely aware at the same time. And five, going down, feeling yourself sinking down. Breathe in and out. You control the pace. And four, going deeper, floating down a tunnel. The light ahead shows you the way. So you drift and glide. And three, even further now, like Alice in Wonderland, you spiral gently down. Down. All the way down. To two. Connecting to images, sensations, feeling your way even further and deeper, and now going all the way down to one as your feet touch a surface beneath you. And you take a moment now to catch your breath. Breathe in and out. The first impression is grey. You make out some vague shapes, and you're not sure at first if you're inside or outside, until a gust of wind catches your attention. Suddenly you become aware of various shades and shapes of grey. Look down. There is grey rock beneath your feet. As you look around, you see a jagged landscape and a stormy grey sea. A sailboat is next to you. You are still holding the rope in your hand, wet. A cliff rises up some few hundred meters in front of you. And above that, higher still, are grey rolling clouds above. A thin grey light dimly shines all around. As you blink and let your eyes come into focus, a whistling wind grabs your attention. It is too cold to stay outside. There are no notable signs of life. And even though it is daytime, it is grey and dark. A distant rumble of thunder is heard to your left, far over there. You look back up the beach again and see a winding path cut into the cliff face. And a tall tower, so large you wonder how you never noticed it was there before. It watches down silently from up top. All lights are off. You turn full circle, but there is no other house or signs of life in sight. You look again, and through the various shades of grey, through the gloom, you see a different movement. A ripple of cloth. A figure stands in a cape, deep purple. And as the air hangs heavy, you make out just one small light. They are holding a lantern, perhaps. The cape flaps in the wind and your eye is drawn closer. The figure is still, turned away, stoic in the turbulent weather. They seem to be waiting. You make your way through the carved path up the cliff, every now and then losing sight of the figure. Trusting that you will find your way as you scramble over loose rock. And as you reach the top and come out on the cliff top, you look down and the boat is just an inky stain on the beach. As you get closer and closer to the figure in purple, guidance is waiting. Look at their face, pale skin, dark hair, patient eyes. The figure is not too tall, certainly no taller than you. Luminous pale skin. an unusual color of eyes. And as the hood of their cape is blown back, you see elvish pointed ears. They tuck the hood again over them and introduce themselves. They tell you they are the guardian of the tower and that you can shelter here for tonight. The weather is likely to get worse, so it is time to come inside. They have been expecting you, but were not sure when you would arrive. You ask them their name, and they tell you. What is their name? Another rumble of thunder. The guide looks up and tells you to hurry inside. Although they do not rush themselves, they embody patience, and you wonder how long they were waiting. They close the heavy door behind you and slide a latch. They reach up and unhook a lantern from the wall and give it to you. It is a heavy stone-lined corridor. Thick slabs on either side, above and below. The air does not seem much warmer than outside. As you take a few steps down the corridor, your footsteps reverberate on the stone. There are two rooms on either side, a small bedroom to one, thin sheets covering a bed, and to the other side a kitchen with a heavy iron stove. A chimney climbs partway up the wall, then out through the side. A kettle is on top of the stove. They ask you now, are you ready for the journey? And they nod upwards. A few more steps in front of you is a huge spiral staircase, also carved out of stone, and a thick wrought iron handrail spirals upwards too. As you look up the tower, there are a few lights, lanterns, guiding the way up, hanging from the walls. Are you ready for the journey? They say to you, follow me. And if you wish, you then decide to go. The noise of the thunder is heard very distantly now. It is quieter inside. Your steps echo as you follow the guide, slowly spiraling up. You hear each of your footsteps, but the guide is silent. You reach the first floor, and the guide now hands you one of the lanterns. They point ahead and tell you, depending on the visitor, rooms come and go. Doors appear and disappear, depending on who is here on each night. And in each of the rooms, only the visitor can enter. The number of rooms for each visitor is neither good nor bad. it simply is. Your imagination starts to wonder what is in each one. And the guide touches your arm to get your attention. They tell you, "I will stay here, but you, and you alone, are the only one who can enter into each room. But if at any time you need me, simply say my name twice, and help will appear. I promise. It is my duty to be here to help. But the journey ahead is for you. I cannot trespass in another person's mind." And they explain, in each room there is something to learn, to gain, some form of freedom. You walk towards the first doorway. The guard takes a few steps, their thick cloak trailing behind. And they stand outside the room. They nod. You look at the heavy door. Breathe in. And as you breathe out, you push it open. You take a couple of steps in. Swing the lantern left to right into the space. You can't make anything out at first. You look back and see your guide. Standing guard, velvet cape and hood, lantern. They are standing alert, but as you look at them, they look back and give you a reassuring nod, then look forward again. You take another deep breath and take your first steps inside. As you go deeper into the dark room, at first you notice nothing. You hold the lantern up, and it seems like nothing. Stone walls. Then you hear the subtlest sound of breathing to one side. You say a greeting, hear your voice echo, breath. You hear movement, a tentative sound, maybe a word or just sound. You walk towards the sound and see a figure. The first thing you notice is they are trapped in some way. Or restrained or imprisoned in some way. You move closer to this figure now. Hold up the lantern. Notice how they manifest. How big or small. How old. This is a part of you that is trapped. In some way, this is some loss of freedom here. Notice how they show up to you. How old or young are they? Do they look human or take some other form? What is the emotion expressed in their face and body? What do they represent? Take a moment to feel this trapped part within you. If you are unsure as to which part of you is trapped, maybe feel inside. What is it within you that needs more light? A voice, freedom to move, to express that part of you. And ask them now, how long have you been here? Why were you put here? Now ask them, what do I need to do to free you? Choose any of these questions and add your own. And now listen to their story. And let them tell you now how you can set them free. Breathe in and out. As the conversation continues, realize that this is the first time in a while, or maybe a longer time, that this part of you has had attention, acknowledgement. Be kind with them. Be kind to you. And they now describe the life you could both have if you set them free. Notice how their expression completely changes. Their body language relaxes as they know what life would be like. And as their eyes shine, they grow in confidence. They seem taller. Imagine what life would be like with this part of you integrated. What would life be like? How would life be different? What would you allow yourself to do tomorrow? Feel the freedom within. What would you allow yourself to feel? What would you stop doing and stop blocking in you? Can you see yourself with this part of you, reintegrated? How do you feel as a whole person? Make this image clear. Don't just see the future, but feel it. Embody it. And slowly and surely, as you allow this part greater freedom, you imagine it, see it, and feel it. You inhale deeply, and your entire body relaxes. As you exhale, you open your eyes again in this scene. Can you notice whatever imprisoned this part of you is gone? and this part of you stands smiling in front of you. They rub their wrists, rub their eyes, and maybe hug you or simply dance with the joy of being free. You look at them again, this freed part of you, and their appearance has suddenly changed. Not just their expression, but they stand upright, proud. They are clean, tall, happy and confident. Now, they tell you, there is a contract you need to break in order for me to remain free. You walk out of the room and the guard nods, looking at your companion. You come to the spiral staircase again, and the guard walks ahead of you both up the next flight of stairs, again gliding up silently. And now two steps of footsteps are heard in the tower. You come out on the next floor up, another room a few steps away. Again, the guard stands outside, and the freed up part of you asks you if you want them to accompany you. You decide. You go to the doorway of the room and push open the heavy wooden door. Unlike the first room that seemed so empty, this is full. Inside, there are papers and books everywhere. This is the room of the records of your life. And in the center of the room, on a podium, is the contract you need to break today. This is related to the part of you that you just freed. Or is some related other limitation? And you can think of a contract in a spiritual sense, something you have carried forward in your soul history, or simply in a psychological sense, an imprinted limitation in your belief system. As you step closer, you wonder what this contract is. Maybe one of imposed loyalty, one of unnecessary lack, one from an unhealthy need, such as a need to please, to conform, some other obligation. Think of those times that you say you cannot, or should not, or must not do or feel something. or be or act as you truly wish to be. As you move over to the podium, you can pick up the contract. And you may see a date when this contract came into place. And what is the title of the contract? And who is this contract with? It may be just with yourself, or tied to someone else. And as you look at this contract, realize what will change in your life as a result. What will you give yourself permission to do? What choices will you have? And now, when you're ready, you can decide how to end this contract. You can sign an end date, an annulment, or tear this up. Whichever you prefer, do that now. And you may wish to repeat a mantra to indicate that this is done. This contract is done, finished, ended. Feel the relief as you see the end of this contract in your hands. Breathe in and out. Feel constrictions in your chest lift, as if you have been wrapped in rubber bands or bandages. Feel that you can fully breathe. And as you walk out the door, just as they promised before, the guardian is waiting. And so is the acknowledged part of you. You take a few steps and look up. And all three of you go up the spiral staircase again. Led by the guide. their trailing cloak calming the path ahead. And you arrive up to the next floor and the third door. But this door is different. It is broken. One hinge out of two is loose. The door hangs at an angle and it looks battered, well used. You have to hold the door with both hands, setting the lantern down, in order to pull the door back. It scrapes along the ground, and someone or something inside the room lets out a gasp of fear, of surprise, and you hear footsteps going to the farthest corner. You pick up the lamp, and you alone enter. You move the lamp up to the level of your face and look hard into the dark. A scuttling sudden movement over to the far corner. You see the shadow. You say hello and hear no voice in return. Just a sound. A whimper or a cry. You move closer, slowly, and reassure them that you mean no harm. Without knowing why, you say, "I am here to help." But it seems that whatever or whoever is there needs reassurance. And you ask them who they are. And they say, "I am the wound. The wounded part of you." This may make instant sense or not. But before you try to make sense, listen. Why are they wounded? And do they represent physical, emotional, psychological, or some other type of wound? Ask them when they were first hurt. And why have they not been able to heal until now? What do they need in order to heal? And now ask, what do you need of me most in order to heal? You may add in any other question as you allow the conversation to unfold. Again, answers may come in symbols, images, memories or emotions, as well as words. Speak and be heard. Breathe in and out. Now that this wound has had a chance to speak, they slowly approach you. As you hold up the lantern, what are the first things you notice about how your wounded part shows up? The first thing you need for this part to heal is to show love and unconditional acceptance. Say and do whatever feels right and genuine. Asking for forgiveness if needed. Explaining whatever is needed to forgive others. And showing them what they need to see and believe to build trust. To start the process of healing. Take a few minutes here. Now you see that they trust you. And in fact, they extend a hand. And you tell them they will never be left alone again. And they truly believe it, just as you truly mean it. And as you make contact with this wounded part of you, noticing already how they have changed, visualize the future with this part of you healed. That tender, wounded part, still bearing scars, but healthy and whole. And when you open your eyes again, notice how they are transformed. Body relaxed, face clean and shining. Looking healthy and nourished, whereas perhaps before they looked neglected. Strong in body, whereas before they may have seemed broken. And they say, let's get out of here. I have no fear. I am free now. And I am with you. And you're surprised to see this wounded part of you healed, now taking the lead. You see fear transform to courage. Wounds transform to scars. The record remains, but the pain is gone. They remind you they have dwelled too long in pain. Time passes by. What is processed and healed is done. And now is the time. The future is still to be enjoyed. And the joy becomes infectious. And as the two of you emerge from the room again, the stoic guard gives you a knowing glance. And in spite of themselves, you see sparkles of happy tears in their eyes. Still mindful of their duties to protect you. And the guard tells you there is just one more room now. You are almost at the top of the tower. As all three of you follow the final spiral up, you stand at the top and look down. And the elf looks so small and so certain. As you look around you, there is something different about this space. This is the top of the tower. And instead of stone, there is a crystal-like ceiling. Curved walls all around. It is as if you are in the middle of a crystal globe. All three of you look around, and you touch this opaque stone. It glows different colors. Sometimes azure blue, softest rose pink, citrine yellow and opalescent. There is a silence in this room, and a gentle, very subtle, pulsing energy. The entire crystal glows as it changes colors. A faint white light, turning violet, golden, tiger eye, amethyst, and the humming energy. There is no need for the lantern here. The entire crystal has a glow. As you look at this globe, you realize that you are at the very top of the tower, and that there is no beacon at the top of this lighthouse. It is the crystal that shines the light. And now the three of you, your healed wounds, your unacknowledged part of yourself, and your original self, now freed of contracts, joins hands in a circle. And with their hands in your hands, you feel the beating of their hearts and become aware of a very powerful, pounding beat as they synchronize with the beating of your hearts. And the crystal globe that surrounds you, as if in the center of a snow globe, becomes brighter and brighter. And as the light gets unbearably bright, even seeing it through your closed eyelids, the power of all three beating hearts reminds you of your strength, as you are one united heart, body, mind, and soul. Breathe in and allow this powerful healing to take place. You see the light fade again behind your eyelids. You open your eyes and blink. And notice that your hands are empty. And you are the only person in the room. As you have reintegrated all parts of you and healed all wounds to become one united mind, body, and soul. Take a moment to feel the changes at all levels. Notice how you feel different. Breathe in and out. And you slowly descend the stairs again. One set of strong footsteps. And you come back down to eye level with the guard again. They nod and say the work is done for tonight. And as you look up, the crystal globe shines brightly high at the top of this turret, re-energized with the energy of your whole, powerful, potent self. You make your way down the stairs, spiraling down. Until you land on the bottom floor again. And the guard pours you some tea. And you sit either side of the warm stove. And as you rock back and forth in the chair, you gently and peacefully settle into deeper sleep. And while you sleep, your life force will shine a light over the seas as other souls come to shore, looking for peace to become their whole and healed self. As your healing energy shines a light for all others who need guidance, this or any other night. And as you sleep, there is any other healing, any other processing, or any other integration . All of this will happen peacefully while you sleep.